definitely had it in mind that she wanted to take Brooklyn down as much as possible.
I don't know, the Gaza girl, they're tough, you know. You know what I mean? Whether you're on the winning team or the losing team, it's not about who winning or who losing a challenge. It's about who do the challenge to the best of them ability.
Well, today we're at the Red Stripe Vibes Sports Bar and Lounge. And standing beside me is Patrice, the owner of Bars to Go. She'll be teaching you all the techniques on how to make cocktails and drinks.
Yo, yo, yo. Different type of girl from all over the world. You need a teacher's pet, anything teacher want, teacher get. Your girl is girl, her girl. Black girl, white girl, brown girl. From the first world, second world, third world. Want be the teacher's pet. Why any girl them love me some? Mm-hmm. I don't know why them are mad over me. I don't know. Woman at Jamaica, woman at Caribbean, woman in America. Where I don't go. One house, one star, 20 girl. Add it up that he want to walk. 20 kids, 20 up, 20 love. But teach only have one ass. Who will get my ass? You have to watch it from the start. And the realest girl can rock my world until that you are star.
Okay, so yesterday was the challenge. We were taken to the Red Stripe distribution area on Spanish Town Road. Bars to Go did a mini presentation in regards to how you make a drink.
Okay, hello.
What's up?
Young lady and young man. How are you? I'm Tia, your bartender today, and I will be making you Tropical Exotic Paradise Rum Punch, of course. And I'm gonna use this rum right here, Myers Dark Original. The challenge was a bartender for Milk, was the young lady, and Ade and Popcorn was the young men that were there. I was their bartender, I made them a drink. Might need a hand here. Well done. I just made it up as I went along because I had on like a nectarine, tangerine, spicy color shirt, and somebody said it was red, and I was like, no, it's not red. It's tropical, it's exotic, it's paradise. And that's how my drink came up, the name. Being as it's a tropical drink, I'm gonna add a slice of banana. Okay, just a small thin slice here to go on the side. The black rum was for the guys. And all that pretty stuff was for meal. So, this is the Tropical Exotic Paradise for you.
Well, what do you think, Papa?
I'll drink a little light.
Yeah, a little light. I like the presentation. What do you think, Mel?
Yeah, I like her personality and just how Tia is normally, naturally. Her drink looks...
qualified.
Yeah, it looks qualified. Fast-paced.
She should have washed her hand, though.
Yeah.
The drink I made was, I named it the Detention. I used the tequila, Johnny Walker, a little vodka, and pineapple juice.
Hello, my name is Monique, and I'll be making for the teacher a drink known as Detention.
That's so interesting. CLM now. CLM was very original. She came up, she washed her hands also. She was very original, even in naming her drink, calling it Detention, and that is really a play on the whole teacher concept.
So this is chilling right there. 2 ounces of Johnny Walker. 2 ounces of tequila as well. I'll be using a 1/2 ounce of the lime syrup.
In the last part of her presentation, she got a little nervous and her nail actually went into the drink. You know what I mean?
Just that somehow my nerves got the better of me when I was trying to put the cherry on the pineapple.
That's it. And this is the Detention.
So it fell in and I just left it. But I think I did fairly well, and he confirmed it saying he liked it. So that was that.
But I think CLM did well. Straight. Like our presentation, everything.
She was nervous like the first girl.
Yeah, yeah.
Halfway she won good.
Yeah, and for the other half it's like downhill. Milk.
She started off good.
But her fingernails are so long that when she was doing the garnish, the fingernail actually dip into the drink and pick up the liquid and stuff.
Very unhygienic.
Bust them in.
I'm gonna make a drink. I'm gonna call it cookies and cream. I'm gonna make it for us because I hear that you don't even drink alcohol, so I don't know how I'm gonna make a perfect drink for you, but drink is gonna be fun, something that you need and work with. So first I'm gonna wash my hands.
TB definitely look definitely nervous as usual, as she always does in every one of her presentations.
You're there making the drink, he's there with his sunglasses on, looking at you straight face, like, I'm gonna tell the truth. That shit just trips me out. I failed my driver's license 3 times because I just don't like people just sitting there just like grilling.
The little whipped cream thing and the little chocolate bar. You know them say if you do everything in moderation. So she didn't really moderate the whipped cream, so to speak. She actually whipped the whipped cream. So.
No strawberries. And no cherries.
Milk, what do you think?
Nice drink. She was kind of nervous, and her nervousness almost kind of just make the thing just go sour.
So to speak.
But it's, she ended up with a pretty drink. I liked it. Tibby, it was okay. It was good.
Yesterday's challenge was the bartending challenge. The drink I'm going to make is called Empire Ecstasy. I just made it up, so first I'll wash my hands.
Katie, you know, she came up with an original name also for her drink. It was called the Empire Ecstasy. You know what I mean? She was very explanatory in her presentation, what she was doing. You know what I mean?
I will use some vodka, which is the key ingredient, spirit. I don't know how much what exactly he wanted from the performance, but I think I did all right. Shake.
But one thing she did wrong was she actually used her hands at one point to take out the sherry from the bottle.
Done.
A nice little drink, Empire Ecstasy.
Yeah, the name bad too.
Only thing she do wrong still, she should have take up the cherry weed, that's something there first.
Yeah, instead of trying to her hand. Actually wrote that down. So that is like a no-no.
I made a drink that had tequila, lime, pineapple juice, and amaretto in it.
Ashley's presentation was also very explanatory. You know what I mean? She was calm. You know what I mean? She did her thing.
And I'm going to garnish it. I garnished it with a lime wedge. So, I don't know how I did.
He made the garnish before actually pouring the drink, which I thought that was kind of a backward movement because, you know what I mean, the bartender, the lady from Barstow specifically told them how to do each step, you know what I mean?
I couldn't taste the drink, so I guess if I maybe tasted the drink, then I would have a better idea of how I did, but it looks good, so I think I did okay.
Perfect. Yay. Thank you.
Ashley,
I like her presentation.
Yeah.
Very explanatory. She explained everything, you know what I mean?
She had the best flow.
Yeah, she had the best flow. A negative is that she actually tried to do something and failed in the middle of the attempt, which was like, what do you call it?
Squirrel.
It actually was a squirrel.
Still to come on Teacher's
Pet. That challenge was something to judge your elimination by. You're gone in your yard from your walk out of the bar.
I was like, damn, I didn't do all these things, and whatever.
Trini a sampling. Trini came up, she definitely was guessing everything that she was doing. You know what I mean? She actually was smelling everything. Like, she took up the lime juice and was like, and she took up the container to pour the lime juice and was like, and that was very unprofessional of her.
I think 2 ounces of orange juice and 2 of pineapple.
It's a non-alcoholic drink?
Yes,
ma'am. The fact that Trini made a non-alcoholic drink, you know what I mean, that was a plus for her. You know what I mean? She attempted to make a mixed drink with non-alcoholic beverage, and it worked, you know what I mean? Because she was the only person who was actually meditating that one on. Cartel no drink liquor anymore. She actually, instead of using the cherry out of the bottle, she used the syrup from the cherry. Yo, her presentation was like crazy funny and just, it was so awkward.
I think it might have been a little too sweet because I was nervous and wasn't really looking at what I was doing. So hopefully I did okay.
In the end, I guess it came out okay. It really did came out okay, you know what I mean? So, I don't know, I have mixed feelings. No pun intended.
Yeah, well, she win with the drink still. You don't know alcohol because the teacher don't drink alcohol. But me didn't expect her to do an alcohol drink because she laugh like she frost.
Yeah, like she was already intoxicated.
Hello and welcome to my bar. This is my bar where I make you a drink. I think first thing
we're
gonna do is wash my hands.
Well, Tommy, now she did. She came and she did something great. She washed her hands. You know what I mean? That is a plus. Because hygiene is very important when you're serving things or food to people. You know what I mean?
Take it to the left. Take it to the left. I'm just trying to shake it to the left. I think I did pretty horrible, but you know, I had fun. I laughed about it after I was done, because I know I was supposed to pour the ice out, and I didn't pour it out. I was supposed to put the little strainer thingy on top of the cup before I poured the drink out. I forgot to do that because I was in such a rush to get out of there.
She started making a mix, and she poured the mix from the wrong container. You know what I mean? And the Baileys, she had too much ice. She had ice in the container. She had ice in the glass that the Baileys was going to be poured in. So it's like it was just like watered down Baileys.
You guys want some straws? That's up to you. But yeah, rum cream and black label. I think this is a manly drink. I don't know. I didn't even name my freaking drink. I was like, damn, I didn't do all these things. And it's whatever.
Never nice.
So what's up? What are you going to make today first?
I am going to make my own concoction of Black Label Black Sexy Fox Drink.
Okay.
That's what I'm calling.
That's so good.
Okay, so first, I'm wiping in this in here so you have a citrus taste. Okay.
Atlanta, she use her hand them too much. And when you're serving drinks and food to people, you have to try to use your hands as least as possible. You know what I mean? Her work here was crowded. She was trying to overdo stuff and she ended up making a fool of herself. You know what I mean? As usual.
Shake your titties, ba bam bam. He wants me to stop. You faking?
Yeah.
This shit don't want to look. Hold on. I think it went horrible. Oh, when I looked in his face and I seen that he wasn't really feeling me and everything else went downhill. I'm a breaking thing, I can't get it out. First, when the glass got stuck in the shaker and the glass broke in the shaker, everything else went downhill from that. The reason why I use the straw is not so I'm not drinking your stuff and so I can see if it tastes right before I give it to you, because if it doesn't taste right, then it's not it. All right. Yes, this was a no-no.
All right.
Thank you, Posse. You're welcome.
I thought about this. Performance, she used her hands too much. And she didn't even wash them when she came in.
Yeah, she cut the lime.
She cut the lime. She used the lime to actually lime up the glass. But she didn't actually wash her hands. And I thought she also used too much ice.
Yeah, and you know what I mean? This straw when she used, she tasted the drinks herself.
Yeah, but never see a bartender do that, yeah. Yeah, so I guess she already...
She drank off of this straw and put it in the drinks again.
Well, I guess she already tasted this, so we have no need to.
Yeah.
River Stone.
Most damn.
The challenge was that we had to prepare our own drink using our own knowledge based off of what they taught us, or just whatever drink that we wanted, and prepare it, and it would be sampled by Vibes Cartel, popcorn, and milk. All right, I think I'm going to make something called Brooklyn's Finest. Okay, that's what I'm preparing. I'm using one of my favorite drinks, which is Bailey's, because that's what I love. And I hope you love that too. Most people do. I think.
Big man, the girl, they make drinks for Vibes Cartel. From she reach around the bar, she talking about, she need a drink. Like, what's it? You come to make drink to somebody and you need a drink. That's like going to a restaurant and the waiter tell us I'm hungry too. You know what I mean? And when he must share your food, he must share a food to himself.
Alright. I hope this thing will fly off soon. Did it ever fly off? In all honesty, I just thought that it was really about how the drink turned out and not really, I wasn't really studying the presentation part. I was a little tired, to be honest with you. We're sitting out waiting for a long time and I kind of get a little restless, so it's like maybe I didn't do that good, but I really wasn't studying the presentation like that. In my mind, it was all about how the drink turned out. Shit. Forget about that.
And her work era was sloppy. She looked uncertain from the start. She actually looked drunk from she came in. She looked intoxicated.
Brooklyn's Finest, who's gonna try this one?
Let's put them right here.
I can't have one.
Let's put them right here for now.
Just to make sure and double check that I was on point, I made myself a drink and took it to go. This way, I can make sure, reassure that the thing come out good.
Brooklyn, if that challenge was something to judge your elimination by, you're gone in your yard from your walk out of the bar. Yes, send it straight back to Brooklyn and tell her to walk.
She look like one transvestite. She just never have nothing else to say because, I mean, me have me breast them, me have everything to show some real. She put in fear, so I don't know what was there before. She walk like a man, she act like a man, she manage. She need to join the Gaza with popcorn and Sean Storm.
I never really talk who was the best, but you see the two worst in the history of worst.
The worst.
Atlanta and Brooklyn. One of the worst, like in the history of worst.
Oh,
now the history of the worst bar presentation looks like in the history of presentation. That was the worst. So.
Say it again.
You hit your teeth?
Yeah.
Don't worry about the teeth when you lick up. Don't worry about the teeth when you lick up. The teeth, alright. Yeah, I can't tell you nobody else how good they did or how bad they did do.
Will
I was just talking
tomorrow?
About like. Huh?
You gonna tell us tomorrow?
Yeah, me, I tell everybody did tomorrow.
The other day, Cartel gave me a call and he said that I'm probably the only girl that he hasn't spent one-on-one time with. So he was coming over to the house to chat with me.
Me and Shinny was in the living room, you know what I mean, just vibing. You know what I mean? I went upstairs to the ramping shop, locked the door with the locks. We were inside, just chilling out. Suddenly, me hear on the door. Boom, 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 boom. You know what I mean? The door was receiving a badgering.
When he got here, he had dinner, and we went up to the ramping shop, and we were trying to speak, but the girls kept banging on the doors, and he was like, yo, I can't deal with this, and I need to drop some things off at the studio. So he asked me if I wanted to go with him. I said, sure, why not? So when we tried to leave the house, Rochelle blocked him as like, where are you going?
Boom. Atlanta in the passage. TB was there also. TB came to me and gave me a hug. So Atlanta was like pulling me like.
He was like, Trini and I are going to touch on the ruin. And she was like, well, if you going, three of us gotta go because we're gonna be one happy family. And he was like, no, you can't go with us.
Yeah, where you come from? I'm a foreigner, you know. Where the man them a foreigner, a girl clown, you know, a Jamaica, you know. Where the real Gaza thugs them are, you know. So me I say, I ask her politely for excuse out of the way, you know what I mean, because we say, you boxer, no master, and Amy. So no brute force, no kick, no punch, no hammers. Yo.
When we did leave, we went to the studio. I got to hear two of his newest tracks. They're so awesome. Like, we hung out there for probably an hour and then we came back to the house and I went to bed.
As it relates to the girls in the house having other masters and being pets for other people. You know what I mean? As it relates to that rumor, which actually isn't a rumor because, you know, life is life. Man will be man, woman will be woman. You know what I mean? I heard that. Well, you know already that Lola didn't come to be the teacher's pet. She was actually Smokey's pet. You know what I mean? Upon elimination of Kashmir, she became Mooney's pet. You know what I mean? And we get to understand that Brooklyn is actually Kevin's pet. With hard evidence.
I don't know. Like, I can't put my finger around it. All I know is one day I was at the Princeville Plaza on Constant Spring and getting my nails done. And that was the day that the chef told me that he was going to grab some groceries for the house. And because I asked him if he could come back and get me to take me to the Princeville, but I ended up going anyway. And I had happened to look out after while I was getting my nails done, and I seen him and Trini walking in the middle of the plaza. And I didn't see no groceries, so, I mean, I don't know.
Come on, I said to you, you can't talk to you from your father. I feel a thing of going on the house, and
I'm going on.
You see what I'm saying? What's going on in the house?
I'm telling you, there when the girl had said that, Brooklyn told her that she called Kevin, and then Kevin ended up telling on himself because he really thought that Brooklyn had went back and told the girl.
Oh, so that happened all long ago.
Maybe like 3-4 days ago.
A true
Tommy? I don't know.
I know that the day I left, I went upstairs to my room, Kashmir, and Brooklyn were downstairs and she was shocked. I don't know if you know
how Brooklyn
carried
herself.
So
me, I want, yeah, me,
when she jumped for me. Excuse me. Hello. Hello. I am on my period, people. You want to see?
Y'all want to see? How long ago was that, though?
Okay. So, thank you. You know I was on my period when we went out the other night, right? Okay.
Okay.
That's a fucking night.
I don't know which night was worse, the night with the pool fight or last night in the kitchen. All right, so last night them try mix me up in a big scandal now that I wasn't really shocked or surprised because as I had said in one of my previous confessions, I was warned ahead of time that I was to expect that you know, these girls in the house, they trying to set me up in, you know, on some alleged rumors, some BS that did not happen. But you know, it's like it's down to the last 9 girls, and people are just getting really desperate.
Last night, a lot of people got drawn out. Brooklyn was standing there talking to Addie, and she was like, how she didn't understand why she did so horrible in the challenge, and that there's other girls that are here that have done bad in all the challenges. And he asked, like, who? And she said, like, Tibby. And I said, listen, I didn't do bad in all my challenges. The only challenge I ever did bad in was the fashion show, which the teacher did agree with. So now when I went to go sit on the stool, Tia said it was time to do the nighttime confession, and Brooklyn got called out because I heard it from a very valuable source that she had sex with the watchman. I don't know why she's trying to deny it.
Yesterday at the challenge, we were sitting around the table and Tibby was talking about Brooklyn and Kevin. So then Tia asked me if it's true, I tell her that I heard, but then seriously, me never see Brooklyn and Kevin before. Me never get no reasons to take them in or nothing. So when them asked me, I said, I don't know, I've heard, but me not have no proof to say it's true or whatever. So that's how it started.
Remember, say a Jamaican will come from. It's not a Yankee.
It's
not far from the place. It's not a Yankee. Remember, Gaza thing.
It's not
a Yankee. It's not far from the place. Don't mix it with no Yankee boy. See?
Yeah.
So Kashmir, you know what happened?
No, but
Kashmir is off. Yeah, we don't talk about eliminating. I'm going to feel like Tommy, no one.
There was rumors going around the house saying that Brooklyn had sex with, I guess, somebody on the production team or security team. I don't know who this dude is that she had sex with. So, but anyway, you know, it was being hush-hushed around the house. They just whispering about it. And the whisper got to me. And, you know, me being the loudmouth, I was like, well,
don't bring me in the hush-hush. Like, if y'all gonna talk about it so everybody can hear.
She's the one that said Kevin Smith. Yeah, oh, you know, as soon as I heard it,
Yeah.
If y'all wasn't picking up on it, I can say
it. But if you say, and she said, but if you say, and she said, it must be true.
No, that is not true.
What you want to say?
Bring him, I'm saying to bring Kevin out here.
Yeah.
I'm saying that
it's day. Yo, please don't talk about that.
Today is day like four. That, yeah. So that's a damn lie. And of course, you got hating bitches in here. They watching me too fucking hard. They watching my every move. Every time I put on an outfit up before I get dressed and get ready. They're concerned. Like they're worried. I dress like a clown, but I won first place in the fashion show. Yeah. And you look like a tramp.
Like, it's funny.
You look like a man.
You had that shit on your suitcase. So, like, you must wear that shit on a daily basis. Like,
I have more than one. You look like a man. You look like a tranny.
Yeah, a lot of these girls is definitely bad-minded, and they all hate me, as you see on the battlefield. You know, I was targeted. My babe came out, and I was definitely her main target. She don't like me.
She claims that she there for wife cartel for the teacher.
Why if she you do something?
But if you do something, she gotta tell me.
And likewise, if anybody else is doing something, I'm gonna come and let you know, like I have to.
That is it.
Right?
Yeah, that's what surprised me. You know, when you were on the other end, you reach on the other end of the.
Does this make sense to you? Did me and you talk about something too much this early?
Yeah, and it was a pretty convincing one. But I guess the girls weren't convinced. Are probably them ear different from what you were telling me.
No, guess what? The girls in here is no. The girls in here is hating them.
You heard anything about
it? Me hear it.
You hear it, Tia?
I already spoke to the boss about this whole situation previously. If he want to fall for the rumors and go by what some masculine females in the house who is hating on the most beautiful girl in here, if he wants to listen to them and run with that story and believe them just because they are accusing me of allegedly having a relationship with a next man in the house.
They hear from Kevin himself.
So bring him out here then, is what I'm saying.
I'm real, yeah? So I'm gonna say what's real and what's been circling around in the house and who's been doing what and who's been doing what. And it's not that I'm a snitch or a informer, but I'm hearing it from all different girls and I'm hearing it from all different sources. So hearing something so many times, there must be some truth to it, right? So what I said was, you know, I did smoke a big joint before I did speak, and you know, so everything could come to my brain. It was a lot of information, you know.
Yo, bring
him in. I see you.
That's
Gaza girl there at the house. But you see you, you say if you one of the realest Gaza, you trick me. But me know you're the realest. But if you're the realest Gaza, something wrong. So you don't really hold back things from me, babes.
Okay. So I've heard a meeting. I had a little meeting with Kevin earlier tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? He had to tell me a few things.
Kevin said that Trini was driving in the car with the chef. Driving the chef's car in the chef, driving the chef in his car, coming in the gate with it. How he knew it wasn't the chef driving, because he came in and the steering wheel was wobbly, right? So first of all, when he said that to me, I had a flashback of last week, Friday.
I thought the same night as the birth night, the New York girl, mm-hmm. I'm going to go fiction.
Mm-hmm.
I remember the chef went in and she had it when I danced.
Who I think started this rumor? I definitely think that this rumor started with Tia, because she sees me as a threat in the house. So they're trying to get all the girls that they see probably as a potential threat to them out. I guess that's the reason for the whole argument.
You know, my heart, me know, say a lie, them I tell Pan Trini. Why? Especially for Tia, initially Trini was not a threat because Trini has never gotten one-on-one time with the teacher. But then she just get a reality check when the teacher called Trini upon her phone and say, babes, me I never spend no one-on-one time before, me need to have some time with you. So that was just a reality check, because now him get to talk to her, him get to kind of figure out her personality. So obviously, Tia is threatened.
So second, they decided to tell Cartel that I hang out with the chef. Of all people, the chef. I think it was hilarious. I had nothing to say because to me it was so irrelevant and it didn't make sense because I know that that's not what I came here for. And I came here for one person, and if I don't get him, when I go back to Trinidad, I know it have enough Trini men that I could choose from. So, the hell was with them.
She was never on the alliance from day one. So, she felt really small last night because her being silent was, everything was like consent, right? Everything, what I said. I only said what I overheard and I said what I saw. How can you be so close with the hell? How can you? That's a major turnoff.
Any prevent, so my pre is always right, prevent. Yeah, still. Yeah, yeah. You understand how my pre actually
so right
now?
I just heard it. Okay. I just heard it. All this I just heard. And but when I hear things, I just don't sit and talk. That's all I was like. I don't want to be talking behind people's backs. I don't want to hear it.
So I send a messenger to send off what
I'm not a man. I'm not a fucking no.
Who comes to me first before came in?
Because y'all would find me sitting behind and
just come to me and tell the shit
instead of talking about it.
I want to talk to him. I want to talk to him. But when I came downstairs last night, you girls were there and you said, I don't need to come to no inn. You know, come and say, Adi, if you get ashamed, just roll ahead and take it and go. That means, not right now, yeah. But if you come, you will not talk. So if you care. Confident, come on, I'm gonna push her in the kitchen, but she ain't ready to tell her yet. Yeah. She make Tommy Black, you know, the champion.
Yeah,
the
man.
Yeah. Champion, just ready for lift up my next bitch.
What the fuck?
You know,
people pointed at me and was like, Tammy, what happened? What are you talking about? And I was like, well, the rumor in the house is that Brooklyn had sex with one of the guys. And, you know, Trini was driving somebody's car and dancing on somebody in the club. And, you know, that's what the rumor is. And, you know, I don't do rumors. I'll just bring it out and open.
Because it's not like she was hiding and saying that.
Where did you hear that
she
from?
She brave enough to come to her face. You see what I'm saying?
I overheard them saying it. I'm like, well, y'all talking about what
I'm hearing
say. I didn't know that. No,
over the red stripe, please. I'm saying, me never take it partner practice. But when we heard from Kevin, the source in what he said.
And when you heard that from Kevin?
Just tonight, me have a meeting. Before we see my book,
your Kevin's a real fucking
start up with confession and that's not even here, so don't come alive at our
confession. Even the night.
Yeah. Yo, I will have
that is my confession.
The bitches is mad because I'm winning all the challenges and stuff and I'm just like too hot to handle, you know what I'm saying? Every time I come, I'm dressed to impress, I'm fly, you know what I'm saying? And I just, they can't stand my swag. They're just not feeling it. And so then bad mind me and try mix me up and make me look like something else, but it's all good though.
If I was going along with certain things and certain things was true, why would I have to make a complaint and talk to them about it? I didn't get catching shit. What the fuck? What the fuck? You acted like you was a witness and you saw me in the street talking. You saw something like that? Were you present? Were you there? Were you there? Did you see something like that?
Listen.
Did you see something like that? No. But you got a bunch of haters that say
this. Hold on, babes. Remember this. No. Hold on. Listen.
If you
have a baby father, right? You have a child by him, right? Mm-hmm. So we know that you slept with him, but we didn't see.
No.
Somebody don't have to see something.
No.
You have a baby father, right? So if you have a baby father, that means we know that you are in the street together. But we never see one in the street together.
That's why I was making all of sarcastic remarks.
That's why I was.
Did not even
but you picked up
like
also.
No,
you
I did. No, because
you
remember,
did.
I
even today when at the challenge by the bar,
no.
when you said, I'm said.
Yeah, no,
remember what I said? When you jump, I said, you know what happens when you get drunk? You remember I said it to you? I said, don't get too drunk, and you know what happened. I didn't say that.
But I heard, listen, because I spoke to you the time we spoke, right? That's what I thought you was talking about. I didn't know that you was making up these stuff.
I wasn't making up stuff. It was something truthful, but Tammy was just brave enough to say it in front of you.
And to him, who's trying to get a little spotlight and the fame, trying to get his name in the mix-up. Yo, you are a real mix-up because you is a big reason, a part of all of this scandal. You know that nothing like that ain't go like that. So, I mean, it's just really crazy. But at the end of the day, Cartel already know who he's gonna, you know, keep for the next round and who's the realest and who's really here for him and all of that.
I even got like a
off-camera confession from Brooklyn saying that, yes, she was drunk and she made a mistake. So with the point of me, I tell you, she is a rummy. And when he's a rummy, they do rummy things. You know what I mean? So that's why she wants to come in at the bar today. She just have this rummy vibe and she wants to drink. And, you know what I mean? So I don't really know if it was a mistake, but I guess she always intoxicated, so she always making mistakes.
Oh. Yeah, so yeah, we got a bunch of haters like up here, you know what I'm saying? Just studying the kid and watching me, you know, come to the fly. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, they just like to make up shit, but I guess if I was them, I'd do the same thing too. You know what I mean? If I look like, you know, them, then I'd be hating on me too, because that's just how it is. But, as I said, if they want to go to that extreme, you could bring some alleged guy on camera, requesting him if you don't want to take it that far. If I have something in mind, I wouldn't want to go that far. Like I said, if I really want to know the whole world out there, it's my time of the month, so I don't know how I could have possibly did something with somebody when it's my time of the month. And furthermore, I'm not here for anybody else except for Vibes Content. So if it wants me, the rumors and run with that, then what can I say? It's up to him.
I heard that some gay party was catching. You went to the gay party?
Wow.
I did.
Okay, wow.
Put them thing there, New York, man. You know, them thing there, don't ask me. Wow. Okay, we are the no head now, so I went. Put them thing there, man, at the domina, so domina, you pass me, man.
They did try to involve me by saying I was partying with homosexuals, but I don't have a problem with homosexuals. And I said I went to the party, stood up, said it, and sat back down. So at least I stood my ground. I didn't turn fake or phony because anybody was around or because the camera was there. I didn't deny who I've known before this. So, yeah, I did. I went and partied and I had a good time.
Oh, if you do that, then you're a part of the teach.
Come here, my girl. I mean, you're like straight man, you know.
only the
Yo, Janio, boy, tonight is a good night. Learn a lot.
I wouldn't take a vegan over to somebody who's cooking a shitload of pork, so I'm not going to take somebody who doesn't like homosexuals over to a homosexual's house. But that's just common sense. But, I mean, that doesn't mean that I'm going to just shut up shop and raw doggy and not speak to nobody.
Still to come.
Okay.
Y'all just have people
honest
who
respect to
Jonesy.
I just
shut
me
up.
Me too, Richie.
Oh, you with me?
Okay.
Everybody, but I mean, she's picking on me and she's picking on Trini, maybe because we're more quiet and reserved and we're not like her, we're not like mannish and screaming and stomping around and swearing at people, so maybe we're just different, so she's kind of put off by that. I don't really know what it is. I never did anything to Tia, but she's starting to get on my nerves.
And when we hear girls say, they were playing to sleep with Kevin, what's up? Ah! And they say, you're shocked. They say, nothing don't surprise me. But them realize, say, we never hear that information before. Yeah, and I say, what? All information here, but we never hear it until tonight. Swear to me. But that's an name, my freemans. And you have to put enough shots to me. Carry back Kentucky, isn't it?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Soul Sick is crazy. I don't even know. Okay, I'm hearing that Soul Sick said that she make a deal with me over some KFC. I don't need to make a deal with nobody on no damn KFC, because I don't even like KFC that much in the first place, okay? So number one, I don't need no girl to treat me to shit, because I'm not into girls treating me to anything. If I was someone needs something, I get it myself, I buy it myself, and I wouldn't be buying KFC. That's not my first choice, okay? I would go to a Jamaican restaurant and buy food. Me and Soul Sick never made no deal about shit. Okay, so I don't know what the hell she's talking about. And as far as the paintball thing goes, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, I was the target that Mobe was coming after. I seen two girls that I wanted to get, the Rasta, she, and Trini. I seen the two of them, and I decided that I was going to run out into the battlefield and take them over. And I started busting some shots. Maybe it was a reckless move, and some of it had the opportunity to get me from afar. And that's how that went down. I never made no deal with nobody, because I'm not nobody's bitch. I'm nobody's girl. No female can rule me. None of that shit. I don't give a fuck if it's Soul Sick or whatever, whoever it is. She's cool. I like her. You know what I'm saying? And she's funny. She cool peoples. But I don't even know what she's talking about. If she must have made that deal, I didn't hear it.
I don't want to leave, but before me leave, why you say Kevin not pursue?
Because all right, Kevin's a bitch.
I never asked you, so.
What did he do?
What did he do to say?
All right, he's trying to make it look like me who got something going on. The other night, when she claimed that I was running around here.
Listen, me, I said, you're sleeping with Kevin, right?
No.
So I like Kevin and tell them.
Yes.
I'm brave enough to tell everybody lies.
And I mean, as much as I love you, Vibes Cartel, the teacher, world boss, and respect to you and everything like that, I'm not going to be desperate like these girls. I'm not going to fling myself and run to you as soon as you come out the car and just run downstairs and attack you and don't even give you space or the chance to just, like, you know what I mean, just walk through the house. That's not my style. I'm not into that. I don't got to go that hard.
So
what
do you want to have yourself in the party with the L? Because if that's the case, if I have something to hide, why would I say why would I say that? Why would I be going to go that far on TV and say, bring the man out and so on? So does that make sense?
Yeah, reverse psychology. We do it all the time.
No, that don't make sense, because he's going to speak his mind. He's going to speak his mind and say whatever he got to say. And if he's telling people that, then he'll tell people that.
When you know it. You know it.
Yeah, I'm
in the
car.
I went to Burger King.
What one?
In the middle.
Come on.
What is that one?
And her phone is ringing. All I see is chef. She's watching her.
I'm the chef. Oh, no, Santa. Who do you know? My mother is in that gym. My wife's going to sleep tonight.
Oh, chef was coming.
She get to sleep in the bed, though. Why is going to sleep?
They say chef was
going to sleep. You are on the other side. You put food in the middle. You want food, not Santa.
Alright, so now Cartel start asking me questions about some other alleged stories that were going on against some of the other girls in the house. And one of the alleged rumors was about Trini, that, you know, she was kind of like a wild girl in disguise, because Trini has like her personality is very quiet in the house. She's a, you know, you always see her smiling and a good spirit and stuff like that. Very quiet. You don't hear her name calling a mix up. She keeps to herself. So, you know, it was a couple of alleged rumors about her going around. And, you know, I did have to confirm a couple of things, because I am here. You know, everybody's here for one reason, for Cartel.
and I'm here for myself, and if he asks me a question, I'm going to answer it. I'm not here defending nobody because we all came in by ourselves and we leaving by ourselves, so I'm really not concerned with the next chick because that's not who I'm here to defend. I'm here about me.
Trini surprised me because I saw her dancing with two girls. She was in the middle of two girls. At first I was shocked because, I mean, when we're in the house, Trini's very quiet. She keeps to herself. You just see her doing a lot of laughing and playing up with the staff, with the male staff around here, and just all over them. So that's the most I've seen from Trini.
I was Vegas. No!
She was dancing with some guy.
Get out
of
here!
And then,
get the fuck out of here, man! Say fucking Calypso, man! Fucking dance hall, yeah? Shake your butt. Let me show them how to do it.
At Persia's birthday party in fiction, right? So when I had that flashback, I remember Trini was in there winding up with the chef. Too much PDA, public display of affection. You understand what I'm saying? And how can you be so close with the help? I'm not the only one who said it. I maybe said it first, was brave enough, and then everyone else jumped
in. I don't want to blow up my boy because he be hooking up a million and stuff like that.
I love your belly, I know that belly. Stop your man, now. Think about it, you know.
But, I mean, they just seem really acquainted, man. I mean, yeah. It's not really my business, but I was just like, wow, I just seen a whole nother side.
So the kick is sweet, the chin is art is really true and belly then.
I don't know.
So I'm going to stop DJ and start. Oh, wait.
Well, I don't know, but me too. I mean, I don't know.
You can't drive an S-class.
You don't know what the fuck
you might have. Who S-class, man?
I thought she was a very quiet, innocent girl.
You can't change my profession. I've never seen a chef drive an S-class.
We don't stay far from. So I'm going to change my profession. But I did not know because I thought she was an innocent, quiet girl. I didn't even know that she.
It has been said that Trini and the chef had sex, and also that they have been seen really close in fiction dancing, and they disappeared in the club. Ashley and Brooklyn both said that Trini and the chef disappeared for about an hour and said they're in the car smoking. And I had personally seen the chef call Trini's phone when we were going to Burger King. So.
On the phone to Kevin?
No, Ashley told me that you were speaking about Kevin and talking about him on the phone all the time.
I probably told my one friend back home.
When she was still out. No, I did not witness nothing with my two eyes, just like he didn't witness nothing with her two eyes either, except for him harassing me tonight. And when I cursed him, and when she was sitting here next to him talking, and I was like, yo, fuck you, leave me the fuck alone. That's what she witnessed. That's what she witnessed, okay? And you know that's what you saw.
You
didn't see me doing anything else.
No, I'm saying
no.
That you were
upset. I was upset. Okay, go ahead. What did you see that night when you sit on here and Kevin was sitting on here?
That I was telling Kevin that I heard about what happened, and you were walking back. Me and Kevin are sitting, so Kevin's not even looking at her, and she's stomping her feet from there to there. Once she catch here, she's looking back at him, and she's cutting her eye at him.
She said, look like a man, but you're supposed to go fat, baby.
Anyways, so Kevin stopped. No, she keeps walking, and Kevin looks up at her like, why is this girl grilling me like that? And she's like, don't fucking look at me. Like, on a
Why a man, but may I use myself as a marker? Me now, but tell the life I'm pussy. Like, why would I do that? Yeah, especially if me and the girl in the house. Why would I tell the life? Say, yo,
no, the operative word. No, the operative word, a man. Yeah. Kevin, I must do a man. Can't lie to.
Exactly. What money? You sound like you come out as a defense liar. I mean, I have no problem with that.
No,
listen. You come out as a defense lawyer, fine. See, what I'm saying, I'm going to put this to you then. Mm-hmm. Why would Kevin, knowing, why are we not supposed to discuss a man? Anyway, why would I use myself as an example. Why would I say, for example, yo,
I fuck
Tilly. And knowing that Tilly and I are in the same house, and I'm telling you, and I'm telling her.
Because he's a big deal.
Maybe because
he's
a loser.
Kevin, I can't
lie about these things.
Kevin act like a friggin' girl, that's why I'm talking,
he's
a talking
back
to man,
yeah.
That's why
I
mean.
Yeah, you understand?
That's why
I'm
saying
Kevin
said
that he
she, are you the one? Teacher said, me come down like me a Brooklyn defense lawyer. It's not a defense lawyer, I'm not a bandwagonist. Me talk about things and me see. Lola gets eliminated, me did see Lola and smoke with me 2 years, me catch her up on several occasions so I can talk about that. Me can't talk about her, me not see her hearsay, cause hearsay can go court. So when I'm asking about Brooklyn, I say, yes, I heard. However, I cannot say that it is factual, I have no proof.
Tia, what you say?
Oh, last confession, yeah. Two nasty bitches upstairs, they can't come around here in live and direct confession. One of the rasta bitch, oh God, I just think like she used to wipe her ass when she shite. You see me? And the fat bitch, oh God, she needs to clean her room. Her room fucked up and just
no, her
yard.
Right now?
No, you look like a queen.
Would you like us to go upstairs?
You look like a queen.
Alright, so let's go upstairs. But please, anything in the bathroom? And I told you, didn't I tell you
that? The helper says that bathroom is a sketch bathroom. But nothing in the bathroom. She says she cleans it in the morning. And in the evening, it looks like when she went back into the evening.
Alright. I have to go to the other bathroom.
The right rasta girl and the fat one. Fat bitch. From Canada. Yeah, nasty. Personal hygiene, like. Them I say the white rasta girl are dread stink. And me say, me can't make up a rumor like that. Me not gonna go into somebody's personal space now. You understand? That's somebody's personal space. Me not gonna go too close to them because me don't want them smell me or me don't want to smell them or. You get what me I say? Only me and my boo supposed to personal space. Yeah, so the personal hygiene thing, them have to go, you see me? Them just. Yeah, so may have to talk about that.
And all that stuff in the bathroom?
In a room. So two girls with the bathroom looking?
No, because other people use the bathroom too.
Other people in the house?
Yes, other
and
people.
And you have your own thing.
You was in the bathroom earlier. You wasn't in the bathroom. All right, well, you use the mirror. You come in and do your hair and makeup. Right?
So she had dirty in the bathroom.
I did not say that. I was complaining about it. What did I tell you?
You're not going to use public bathroom.
Oh, dirty in the bathroom.
That it's disgusting and
but there's only two girls in the room, so
we're not the only two that keep
you got to push on.
You listen, you got to really take the blame because you should have told that fat bitch, listen, yeah? You're in the room with me, fat bitch, you nasty bitch. Clean up your fucking shit. That's what you should have told her. Well, not in my room, I tell those bitches, get the fuck out.
But you come in our room, you wasn't in the bathroom earlier, today
is the first day since I left that room.
Alright,
don't
waste
that bathroom because I don't like to go in that bathroom, it's disgusting and I often,
really?
When I was in the room, I said to Ashley, please clean up after yourself after you leave, because I can't deal, I don't live like that, it's just disgusting.
When I told her, they came in
the bathroom, 0 bucks 7 under bed, she was rolling and sleeping, I promise.
She rolled and I'm sleeping in her trunks, but bed full of all.
No, girl, I asked her to sleep because she told me no, she's not girl because she didn't feel like doing it at the moment. And I told her, I said, look, they talked to us about she needs to go inside. She said, no, she's not going to do it. And I told her, because all that stuff scattered on the back of me, what about the clothes, all kinds of things, stuff, gear, all of it. None of that stuff belongs to me, nothing. Anytime I go in the bathroom, and if I bring it in, I take it back out with me. So, at some time back to the store, the stuff that I sent to the stuff that I need to sit. I have to go.
Right.
Yes, I have to go back to the hall.
Yeah, well, that makes sense.
It's to that point. But it's not just me and she alone in the bathroom, but I try to avoid that because the reason sit in my stomach. And I'm not a nasty person. And my mother raised me much better than that. You know what I'm saying? I gotta keep the place clean and tidy. That's what I'm used to. That's my
upbringing. So that room, so basically that room there, that room there is the infidelity room. That room there is the infidelity room and it's the kitchen.
There was a complaint that the bathroom that we're staying in was dirty and stuff like that. I'm a very clean person. I stay cleaning my spot using bleach and Dettol and wipe down and scrub down. As you can see, I'm dressed to clean right now, even though I'm not. And the point is, my mother raised me better than that. But I'm not gonna clean up after no female. All I could do is just talk to you. If you wanna keep your things slack on, dirty or whatever, then that's on you. I'm not here to clean your shit. I'm nobody's fucking mate. You understand me?
The room is okay, may I have a crack in it. May I have a crack in it. In my room. And my room could have said so. You see me? Okay.
Is it in the same geographical space?
Yeah, no.
Is it in the same geographical four walls?
But her side, I'm not going to go make up her bed. I'm not going to go.
So what's the difference between that side of the room and this side of the room? Because it's the same.
Oh, I don't know. So I'm supposed to clean up after?
I'm not putting anything in your mouth.
So what is the difference in it? What are you suggesting?
Well, silence means consent.
I can't stand her, and she starts making up lies about me, so I have to step in and correct her lies.
Say I'm not, no. let's go, let's go. Hello, good morning. Hello, good morning. Know you've been waiting, waiting for it. Cause I see you watching. So let's go, let's get it poppin'.
To draw me out and say that the chef was feeling me up, and I didn't like the manner that she put that in, because that is not what I said to Monique. What I said to Monique is, every time I pass the chef, he's making some smart remarks and he's trying to like grab my leg or rub my leg. It was nothing to the extent that it needed to be said that he was feeling me up. The second that it turned into a way that I felt like he was coming on too aggressive or it was bothering me, then I would say something to him.
So what the man said, she said, that's not that does my food. But because in the same way, so if you want to not take food, but chef must stop, rub on the ground.
Oh, God.
The chef said, I'm good at that food game in Democracy.
Wow.
You're not telling me nothing. So what are you doing?
Me?
Yeah.
Nobody.
Do you want a cuddle? Oh, come and give me a cuddle. Oh, let me show this bitch.
Hot.
Too close.
So sick and my beard is going extra hard, toe to toe it seems like now. It's like they're almost going toe to toe at it for cartel, and they kind of broke out into an argument last night in the kitchen, which I was surprised at.
The Mobay girl, she had a lot to say. She had a lot bottled up inside of her. A lot of hate for Tia. Yeah, so she had to release it. But I had to put her in her place. Yeah. I'll fart and fart, Pana.
Because she has talked about Trini, it's not like
she
has to defend her about.
But you are, you're defending
her. No, I'm not. You are. I'm not. I'm not. I said you don't say things that you have no evidence. She goes to club every night, so she would have known I've never been, so we can't say whatever. Yeah.
More than one girl tell me something to Trini about body in the club. Like, I don't know, well, I don't know, but if you go up with something, you feel like our Trini's are sleeping.
We can't argue with both.
You
said
you got
the
something.
And
she have a comfortable back. We're like different right now. Right now, Trini, look on her. She have a come tell me that. Even if she have a man. Even if she have a man. Even if she and the chef have a pop. If you have a something. She still have a come tell me that. That is a woman's fear. That is a woman's fear.
I'm going to get up on the camera. Go back and sleep.
I can't keep you sleep.
$8,000 breast job, but that still don't change the fact that she have more male hormones. She have to put makeup up on her ass. That's just ridiculous. I think one of the challenges should have been everybody just naked and stand up, and them the teacher just do an inspection, because I think he would get a rude awakening.
No one or nothing. You don't even categorize me fucking. No one cares. Not fucking thing. Okay? You can't fucking style fucking me. Alright, bitch? Go to the fucking one. Take that wig off your fucking head. Alright? And get a couple of fucking look like that. Alright?
I'm
just
gonna come check and say you have to be a natural born female. Stop ever passing for that. You're not as much as they think, Tia. If you think that because there is a whole lot of rich man out there looking at
who looks like this?
You think you're not
better?
Soulsick was, you know, telling her, basically telling her that our skin are torn and it weren't heaving out and she tough like turbot and all kind of mix up.
In a fair head, she said she's so sick, but seriously, she's so sickening.
She needs to tone. She too shine for the camera.
You need to tone, my girl.
I mean, the only shine on this phone buckler. Give me a second. Big man thing. I mean, Sir Michael Gates was just.
You run.
straight.
I don't know what it's called. It's not necessary.
I just bad mind that don't like ugly. True grown, I'm here real. And everything about me act, but cute. And she don't got what I got.
Yeah, right.
Okay? That's what it's really about.
Yes, I look like one transvestite. She just never have nothing else to say because I mean, me have breast them, me have everything for show some real. She put in fear, so I don't know what was there before. She walk like a man, she act like a man, she manage. She need to join the Gaza with popcorn and Shantstorm.
God, that's that fucking ugly. That fucking town, bitch.
Toe,
okay?
You're pretty sure that you're still not at here. Yes, sir, you're supposed to get so sick, just relax. And then finish.
Because
I'm
going to
really
use the lamp. What was the cousin for? Just said the two ones coming from Mobi. What you say now? Only two ones coming from Mobi and the eight one of the guys. I'll do what I'm not friend. I'm the one going to be friend.
We don't roll with other girls.
So you're not eight hours.
So
what
you're not roll with any of you. We don't roll with all the wrong ones on the car with strips. Look, come up on far by then.
She shine, she no cool for the camera, for the CVM TV. Yeah, she need for chill in her room and take the AC and come out cool for the camera. That's when, yeah, like how me look cool, you know, yeah.
In the contract, I saw that you have to be a natural born woman, but Tia and Tammy, even Tibby the pon the borderline too with that. No really look like woman, seriously speaking.
Everything does so pre-op, so it's a pre-op. I mean, it's sick.
My dad's got me to make fun of
me. You see, as big as you look, as strong.
Yeah.
Oh, if you can't fight in front of us, Captain. That's big for me, I say. As strong as you think on it is.
She don't want to cross this.
Not this. This. So that man try to tell me, so when you can't go and talk all in the man, let's try to fight right now. When you can't do it, when you're not so bad, I mean, I'm a really bad man. Don't think it's a jail with this. I don't know. So I don't mention explain, so we cannot cuss on a one and have to kill up on the same wicked. And then I know we get.
Me alone, you can't trace.
And then I know we get.
Me alone, you can't trace. Well, you can't trace the guy.
Go on! I know we get, my girl.
Okay.
When I can't cuss, but we don't know
when I. Queen! I trace. Okay.
And then somebody will find you one of my strategy.
Okay? I don't know who you think you are, okay? Okay, what you think you are, that's just like she get that tracing. When you try to style this, you try to style this, you get that tracing.
Good money, woman.
Okay,
yeah.
We don't even fight that bitch up here. Okay, and whatever I say is the realest shit. It's the realest shit. Whatever I say is the realest shit. Because I'm the realest bitch. I'm the realest bitch up here, okay?
Enjoy our time here, enjoy toilet love.
Bitch, go do a liposuction and go to wash your dread and fuck off.
Realest bitch on the biggest tits.
Listen, go wash your dread in the toilet, man. That's what you need to go to, man. Mm-hmm. Oh, what's your dream? You come to the toilet.
Realistic.
Okay. Realistic. Yeah, it's a lot of good expose in the body painting because I'm a realist bitch.
Real.
Okay?
Real fake.
Okay. Best looking bitch, okay?
Okay.
No hate because you can't even walk in fucking wheels. Okay? You can't even fuck. I tried to teach you today how to walk in fucking wheels. But you can't fucking walk in wheels. I tried to fucking show you how to walk
But you can't. So what? They go clean on your jar. Get the fuck out of here. Clean on your jar and go wash your drink, man.
I want a name too hot for TV. Yeah?
No, what a chance, Kevin.
I want too hot for TV. Trust me. Right, that night I do. The fighting thing. Don't mix me with the man that I fought to fight the other day. I really level this, yeah. Don't fight me on the teacher. You know the way there? Yeah, you know they look strong. Them can't fight in front of Vice Carter. But I love them, just try. Please. You know the way there, sir? You don't know what I'm gonna say. So just kill the argument.
I won't even waste my time.
They was just going back and forth, confronting each other. A couple of insults and stuff was thrown out there, and it got real heated. At one point, I thought they was going to fight, but Cartel said no fighting allowed as long as he's there. They definitely couldn't do that in front of him. So that's how that went down.
More
beer than
there,
you said.
Chef, I rubbed
down
your foot, man, like it. Rub down your foot. Chef, I wash fruit. Yeah, you wash fruit, careful, yeah, rub it. Rub off the thing. So money, you tell me, say, Chef, I rub it up. Yeah, I'm not here. I'll tell you that. You have a quality punch in? What's the water here? What's that squeeze? You can't see you.
Yesterday, the teacher kept making comments saying that my pussy was fat, and he asked me to squeeze it for him so he could see. And I did. He said that he could see my camel toe. That's what he said.
Hey, come on. Oh, you touch your butt?
No.
Oh.
It's too late now. It's like.
Oh, we're not chilling around. We never know.
What's happening?
Oh, that was true.
Oh, you met my
eyes. Alright, guess, guess, alright, guess. And then, oh.
Funny.
Alright, hello.
Yeah.
Next week on Teacher's Pet.
The final person who will be staying with us in the Pet Mansion and who will still be in the running to be the Teacher's Pet.
See, right now we are shocking vibes through them. This is my life. Music, this is where I record a lot of hits.
We have a new addition to the mansion and her name is Candy. She comes all the way from Trinidad and Tobago. Girls, this is Candy.
Yo, 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 different type of girl from all over the world. Want to get a teacher's pet, anything teacher want, teacher get. Your girl is girl, her girl. Black girl, white girl, brown girl. From the first word, second word, third